Part 1 of this documentary series explored the deepest, darkest side of TikTok, revealing the story of Kenisha Davis, a controversial TikTok user involved in scams, manipulation, and the abuse of animals. Kenisha, along with her on-again-off-again ex-husband Kyle, moved into a house to take care of Kyle's ailing mother, Stacy. However, Kenisha later exposed the terrible conditions of the house and the neglect of Stacy. She documented the situation on TikTok, including secretly recorded phone calls that uncovered disturbing conversations. The video also revealed the shocking discovery of dead animals in the backyard, including a rotting dog chained to a tree. Kenisha's actions and admissions implicated her in the neglect and abuse. The video ends with a plea to share the documentary to raise awareness and prevent the animal suffering from being in vain. Thanks to the valiant efforts of TikTok panels, concerned watchers, and Facebook posts, Max was rescued.
Part 2 of this documentary will revisit the entire year of 2023 in whole. We will deep dive into every lie, scam, and scheme Kenisha tried to pull this past year. A huge trigger warning: if you are sensitive to animal abuse, possible SA or cancer miscarriage lies, stop now. Let's begin. The year starts off seemingly peaceful, with Kenisha living in her boyfriend John's uncle's trailer. However, it doesn't take long for chaos to ensue. On January 10th, we witness Kenisha quickly covering the camera as John allegedly throws something at their cat for climbing on the dresser. John defends his actions the following day, claiming he was merely trying to scare the cat to teach it a lesson.
Hey, do me a favor.
Mm-hmm.
Cover the camera. Get off my dresser! You're okay.
Just 2 days later, on January 12th, things take a shocking turn. John feeds Kenisha alcohol while she fills out job applications live, becoming visibly drunk. The situation escalates as they engage in a sexual act off camera, with Kenisha later expressing discomfort and pleading for John to stop, claiming he has gone too far.
Honey. It's your fault. Henny, stop that.
I know, I got you. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but this show is about to end. You
don't,
guys have a good night.
Don't hang up yet.
Oh, I am.
Don't hang up
it's
yet.
It's your time, baby.
The next morning, Kenisha replays the live stream and receives messages from her online chat, urging her to leave. She confesses that John has assaulted her, setting the stage for a dramatic turn of events. John and Kenisha embark on a trip to Paris, but their relationship takes a further nosedive as a fight breaks out, leading to John leaving Kenisha stranded in the city. In a live stream, she accuses John of hitting her and reveals a physical altercation with John's brother. However, leaked texts later suggest that Kenisha may have fabricated some of the details. On January 17th, Kenisha and Kyle seek refuge with her mother, April. They find themselves in dire circumstances, frequently begging for basic necessities like food, toiletries, and even cigarette money.
January 25th introduces Kenisha's ex-father-in-law, David, who attempts to mitigate the fallout when Kenisha is accused of taking money from TikTok after claiming she was done with Kyle.
Grown adults. Together?
Great. That's on you guys.
I've done it before. I've gone on to it before about begging and shit. I've called her out on it myself personally about it. But the thing is, what she does is on her.
Despite the chaos, Kenisha and Kyle officially become engaged once again on January 30th. Meanwhile, we learn about Autumn, Kenisha's best friend, and the missing bike.
I have a bike lock, and the bike lock's on it, but I have the key and it's at home.
There's no word to put the lock of a bike in here.
Well, not only that.
That will come apart.
Word. Well.
I can get away with that.
But still, I just need a bicycle. So I can
still.
Yeah, I'll walk over
as Kenisha and Kyle spend time at the church rec center, they find themselves entangled in battles with other scammers. On January 31st, Kenisha's brother informs David of a physical altercation between him and Kyle.
Good.
Yeah.
Hope this time they get the shit together and make a go of it.
Yeah. I ain't gonna lie, there's some things that, like, he's too scared to tell my sister, like, sometimes, you know what I mean? I'm like, Bo, you gotta tell her, you know what I mean? Me and Kyle's gotten fights before. We got in a fight a couple days ago, man. But he's the best one for my sister, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hey, be proud of
yourself. They are twins. Who's twins?
Hey, here's something you'd be proud of your son on. You know how he usually doesn't stick up for himself a lot?
Yeah.
I've been telling him, like, you need to start sticking up for yourself. Knowing people don't know of your shit. And I was testing him one day, and then it kind of got, we ended up getting in a fight. But I told him, I'm like, besides the fight, bro, even though he doesn't know how to swing, you know what I mean? I said, I'm just happy that you swung. You know what I mean? He took a boot to the head. A couple punches, he got me in the neck, you know what I mean? He's getting there.
Yeah. He needs to start taking up for himself. I told him that a long time ago.
Yeah.
They're letting people walk all over him.
Yeah. Yep, that's what one
But they both feel. They both need to do that. They both need to quit letting people walk all over them. They both need to get their heads out of their ass and start getting the shit together. Go on,
February begins with the revelation that Kenisha has left her cat, Sephora, behind, marking the first of many abandoned animals in her life.
We don't know. We're trying to find her.
It is during this time she adopts the nickname Kiki.
You like people with speech impediments? Kiki. You guys called me Kiki so much I put it on my wrist.
Hey, you're the one that said you like the nickname.
I do like it.
Kiki.
A lady claims to have sent Kenisha $200 but asks for it back after April reveals Kenisha's alleged drug use during a live stream.
Just word of warning, put your shit up. Good. You know why? Someone called their local police department and said they're gonna have your house raided. The cops are going to be showing up at the apartment to have it raided. Can you hear me now? The cops are going to be showing up. Someone called the local police department. If they have a warrant, they can. Mom, you're on parole. They can come in at any point in time they want.
Hope. Yeah, I'm trying my best to hold up.
Did anyone else send anything?
You still got 58. They asked if your mom had enough money for food.
No, she doesn't.
That's why she's in there crying right now.
What? Anthony?
I just said no, she doesn't. I answered the question. Sorry, I'm irritated.
Yeah. Just say yes or no.
Hmm?
Mm-hmm. Is that what the... What
you... Yes. Like, it's not on the arm, it's in the mouth. Yeah, but...
What do you need help getting?
I can't really say that.
That's the question.
Let's just say my mom's out of her supply.
She never sent me $200. I can pull up my transaction history right now and prove to you she never sent me $200. And honey, I'm 20. She said she was going to, but never did. She needs to stop lying, stop trying to start drama. Unnecessary drama, because if she sent me $200, I would have food right now. I wouldn't be trying to find a way for food. Good morning, honey bunny. Yeah, because apparently someone sent us $200.
Yeah, I wish.
Yeah, me too.
If that happened, I'm fucked.
Oh, I'm great.
Kenisha adamantly denies these allegations.
That is not what I said. I said I owe my mom $20 because she bought food the night before. Don't twist my words. Yeah, it'd be Giles if I was, but I don't think I am.
She bought us pizza nuggets.
Yeah, my mom bought us pizza nuggets. I said I owed her $20. I never said that I was giving her money for her supply. And if you're talking about that video, I said, someone asked what's wrong with my mom. I said she is out of her
supply. Additionally, fake pregnancy storylines resurface, adding another layer of intrigue. On February 8th, Kenisha attempts to gain sympathy from her chat by begging for sanitary pads and food.
Hey. Yeah, there's a window. I was talking to them. Why are you guys so obsessed about what my mom's doing? Stop worrying about my mom. It's none of you guys' business what my mom's doing. It's good. The only thing I'm lacking is food. That's what we need. We don't even have food for work. And I need pads. That's another thing I need, which I don't have. I have maybe two left. Can I do a food bank? Nope, I'll be working. I might actually look for a different job though, because my body can't handle the 12-hour shifts. I almost passed out like three different fucking times. Oops. Three times. Sorry, Lord.
She successfully receives money for both, but later squanders it on unnecessary items at Dollar General.
Yeah, you get the brownies on the card.
I want pickles.
Let me go grab a cart, you
know? Anybody like sweet pickles? Anybody?
You want Pringles? Mom says she wants Pringles.
Pringles? If she wants to walk all the way down to my mom's house, I'll get her some Pringles.
That'd be like 10.
You've never had pickles in your 28? Yep. Go ahead.
Can we get
this? Is that the four? 8, 9, hold on, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Yay, nay,
and both. I guess. I'm buying food from a Dollar General. That's not it. I'm at Dollar General. Like, seriously, just... shut the fuck up.
I'm at please.
No, I just got kind of food and because my boyfriend convinced me, but I haven't tried them yet. The sweet pickles are the best. Oh.
He's out of luck.
Yeah, he is out of luck. Get him cream pies.
These are
the both Debbie. I don't care, just get the cheapest one.
Cheapest one? They're both the same higher.
Hi.
Same price for more.
I bet.
What? Where did David go?
Although I'm pretty sure mom's cousin won't understand if it goes out. If I need help.
Where did David go? Did someone block David again?
If so, then you need to fucking quit. That's my dad. I
didn't
do anything wrong, so
I'm gonna call mom.
Did McCain have your old phone?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Stop. Hold on, I'm trying to think. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
That's 3, 6, 3, 65, 3, 15. 18. This is how much?
220.
We'll be able to get it. We'll just have to use some of his
money. I don't want to use his money without asking him. Why? I wish I had a little bit more because I can't really get shit. Ooh, pregnancy bagels. Has anyone had pregnancy bagels? They are so fucking fire. My day's been mint. Danishes. Cherry. Those look good. Pregnancy bagels, yes. It is a bagel, cream cheese, melted butter, and regular cheese slices. Savannah, what's up, girly?
After overhearing Kenisha's plea, her pastor offers her a ride to the food bank, but she declines the assistance.
Do you know yet if you will be scheduled to work next Wednesday?
Yes, I will be.
Oh, okay. So I was going to say you will be eligible for the food pantry by then.
Yeah.
February 11th brings another
all right,
setback
thank you.
As Kenisha is fired from her factory job for being a no-call, no-show, citing a visit to the ER for mental health reasons.
I'm hanging in there. Nope, I lost my job due to being in the hospital. Because I was unable to call in because they took my phone. That's all right. I'm going to call back up to another restaurant and see if I can get hired on there. Do you need help with money? That's, like I said, that's always your guys' choice if you guys want to help out. You don't have to, but it's appreciated. Yeah, they can fire you for that. Because I was working through a company, and it basically is technically a no-call, no-show, and they can fire you for it. Yeah, I got fired for being in the hospital. Can I show proof I was in the hospital? Can you get my jacket, babe?
Yeah. Your heavy one or your hoodie?
My heavy one. It's in the side.
Open the bed. I don't think you're gonna end up stepping on that.
Then cover your eyes, honey, if you don't want to see it. They're asking for proof. I don't want people to think I'm lying, so I'll show proof. It's in the side pocket. Inside pocket. Inside, baby.
If I can get my fat hand out of it.
So proof I was in the hospital. Hold on, I'm showing you guys. Give me a second. Oh, show proof to my work?
They won't care.
They won't care. It's a no-call, no-show. That's how they see it.
Yeah, because the people that do it through the terminator things are the dick ones.
But
the dicks of the agency.
Here, in my paper. Backwards. Well, hold on, I'll flip the screen so you guys can see it. It's going to disclose my hospital information, but I don't personally give a fuck. Let me flip the screen. Someone said they couldn't see it. I know my number's on it.
What, other than your phone number?
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. Someone tried calling and harassing. They're gonna get it. Was charged for harassment charges. Right?
In a puzzling move on February 13th, Kenisha spends her food money on lottery tickets for her mother, April.
I promised my mom I'd buy her a lottery ticket, so I can't. So I just got a Lunchable. Instead for dinner.
All kinds of feelings.
Yo!
Hey,
brother. Cops are going to my mom's school. Congratulations. They ain't gonna find anything.
Nope.
Well, you're gonna get your ass hit.
I'm so sorry. My purse just hit that fucking little kid. I know, but I made a promise to my mom, and I'm
good,
ride it all the way back.
I wish.
The financial decisions become increasingly questionable as she announces on February 18th that she and Kyle are actively trying to conceive a baby.
Do you want to?
Well, that's the whole point of us buying pre-seed. If we're not going to use it, then why did we buy it?
When were you using it, woman?
Okay.
When she goes back live. What do you mean? I'm gonna message this girl and I'll be right back.
Okay. She disappeared. That's so depressing. I also need new socks. I've been wearing these same socks for the last couple of days. Yeah, we are. My fertility clinic recommended it until we can have his count tested. I'm not going to say exactly the word, but his count tested. Because they say that men, what my OB said, men are 35% of the reason why a woman can't get pregnant. The other 65 would be a woman. And if his count's normal,
boom,
then they're going to send me to a fertility clinic. But they want us to continue trying with pre-seed and on our own.
Desperate for food, Kenisha convinces her ex-boyfriend, John, to allow her access to his EBT card on February 19th, as her supporters were hesitant to buy her food directly.
So what's your guys' plans for the day?
Nothing really. The only thing we're trying to figure out is how we're going to get food, but that's about it. That's the only thing we have planned for today.
Don't you still have a picture of the link card? Of my link card?
No.
Okay. I'll see what's on there and I'll send you a picture of it.
Okay.
It won't be... No surgery. I don't think there's probably more than 40 on there, but... Actually, let me look at that real quick.
On February 24th, we witness Kenisha filling out an EBT application at the library while Kyle casually vapes at the computers.
I'm fine now. Stop tickling me. I'm trying to fill out this application. Gee, nothing gets past you.
What?
You can't do that in there.
No, kick my ass.
It's 4:42 here.
Are you doing something you're not supposed to be doing to somebody? We just got a complaint.
I'm filling out an application. That's what I've been doing. Okay. This is the second time. It's really starting to piss me off. Can I fill out an application? Can you guys stop, seriously? Because if you guys get me kicked out of the library, I'm going to be
pissed. This period, Kenisha is frequently seen taking medication, adding another layer of mystery to her story.
Thank you, Wendy. I got your $10 that you sent me.
During this time, we are introduced to Stacy, who communicates with Kenisha through phone calls. In a surprising twist, Kyle proposes to Kenisha while on the phone with Stacy.
What is it?
Close your eyes, hand out.
Okay, I'm in my room. Watch it there better.
I'll land. Good.
You said John said I had something to tell you.
No, Sean told me that he had some news about you. And I tried calling him when I got back and he didn't.
If I'm gonna stick on this hand, this finger right here.
I don't hear it. Now I told you that I was going home, so. and they only got 1.75 liters off me today, which is good. But he had a campfire going in. So it was red fluid. That makes blood.
Don't know how to put the eye again.
Oh my gosh.
I just got it. Okay. Are you mad?
Not to do it? Yeah, I know.
She also told me if I did do it, you would say no.
Yeah.
You know?
I never said I would say no.
That's what she
Kane,
said.
Okay. Kane asked me this morning, if you proposed to me, what would I say? And I said I would say yes.
Autumn said that. You said
I told
no.
Autumn, she said you should say no because she thinks it was too soon. Which it probably is, but...
To celebrate, Kenisha and April engage in an impromptu twerking session in the living room, broadcasted live.
February 25th brings another bizarre occurrence as Kenisha learns that her church has been broken into.
See what he wants.
This becomes a recurring pattern, with every place she visits seemingly being ransacked and robbed.
They usually keep that church unlocked. The church is always locked when there's no one there. Why?
Because we're redoing videotape. Somebody broke into church yesterday.
My church?
Yeah. Starts with breaking into it.
Who?
Let me find out. Someone broke into soul shift my church, I will break their fucking fingers.
No, I'm live.
I don't give a shit if I'm on live. That's my fucking church. That is my second family. That is the only fucking people that has been there for me when no one else has. Roger
Watch
literally
this.
Cleaned the blood off my fucking arms when I walked in there bleeding. Roger cleaned it up. That is my fucking family. I don't fuck around when it comes to you. You can mess with this family, but you're not gonna fuck that family.
No, when everyone knows that, they keep the doors locked.
Sorry, I apologize for my language, guys. Sorry, my mom has roaches.
At some point over the next few days, Kenisha is admitted to the hospital, disappearing from the public eye until her reappearance on March 4th, leaving viewers eagerly anticipating the next chapter of her unpredictable journey.
I'm good. I don't really want to talk about why I was in the hospital. I was in there a week. Well, close to a week. I was in there 5 days. But.
March 7th, Kenisha returns to the church, desperately seeking a hotel room.
Oh, just imagine a night away.
That would be awesome.
Actually get some sleep.
Yeah.
No, I didn't just quit. I was in the hospital. Kyle just quit. I didn't quit. I was in the hospital when I lost my job.
I'm gonna put this high cord.
After getting the funds for the room, she ends the stream saying she will live stream from the room. However, to no one's surprise, Kenisha doesn't come back.
Guys, I'm gonna go live when I get to the hotel, okay? I'll be right back. I'll see you guys when I get there. Bye.
Days pass, and it isn't until March 10th that she reappears. Kenisha is now in a hotel room with Autumn, engaged in a heated conversation with her father, Aaron.
You laugh.
Look, I'm just gonna put it out there like this. Anybody gonna wrap their hands around your neck, it's gonna be me. Because I ain't gonna let anybody else accuse my kids. If my kids need their ass kicked, it's gonna be me.
Ow.
Ain't that right, pinball?
Yep. So apparently blocked David. Whoops.
Thank you, whoever that was. I appreciate that. You know, we're all sitting here having a good time. We call Kyle. He's laughing, you know. And then he has to get out here and get super serious. And
they are discussing David and Aaron's fight over them teasing Kyle.
I guess here's my question. How old is Kyle?
21.
It's time to stop changing his diaper.
We got the cereal. It's my mom's favorite kind of cereal. Ow, can't get the ring off. Can't get the ring off. Ow, fuck. Sorry, excuse me.
I mean, if you want to replace the hamburgers, then you're more than welcome to.
I was not talking about the whole hamburger thing. It was before that. Before what? Join the... David. Then what
somebody,
were you...
Somebody blocked him.
Then what were you talking about? Because there's literally...
It doesn't matter what you're talking about. Somebody please block him. We're all trying to have a good time. Autumn, do me a favor. Call Kyle and have him call his dad and tell him that everything was a joke.
Okay.
Thank you, hon. God, it's ridiculous. Everybody laughing for the last 45 minutes takes one ignorant person to screw it all up.
Oh, my shoulder.
He pressed the fuck you button on me.
Kyle pressed the fuck you button.
It's messy and be like, hey, I really need to talk to you.
Probably him losing the job in the hospital thing. Well, that situation, you can ask my whole family. He didn't even show up. Both times I ended up in the hospital, I was there by myself over 17 hours. By myself.
If you're going to quit your job, you should be there by your significant other. And you being a man should not support the fact that he quit his job and wasn't there by his significant other. Period.
The last time I was in the hospital last week, he was supposed to show up. I waited over 8 hours for him to show up before they transferred me to the hospital, and he lied to me and said the hospital wouldn't let him there when I was asking every hour on the hour, where's Kyle at? Where's Kyle at? He hasn't showed up. He hasn't showed up. So if we're gonna be serious, let's talk about the real things.
And I don't know if y'all remember
that. I agree with the hamburger thing.
I don't know if y'all remember me talking about this 4 or 5 months ago, but men ain't men anymore.
He is a Kyle. It's just sometimes he makes dumb choices.
No, I don't support him quitting his job. In fact, I jumped his ass about that. Then what are you talking about?
Yeah, just drop it. I have very little tolerance for ignorance. I'm going to tell you right now, when I was married, if I went to the emergency room, if my wife wasn't by my side, hell would have broke loose.
During this argument, Kenisha drops a bombshell revelation. She discovered gay porn on Kyle's phone.
They're never going to let that go.
Should we bring up the gay porn?
Probably not.
We should not bring up the gay porn.
You just did, you idiot.
Autumn said it first.
Oh my god.
Tell us! They're like, tell us!
Okay, should we tell them the secret behind it, though?
No.
Okay.
We should probably let this one go.
They're never gonna let that go.
Should we bring up the gay porn?
Probably not.
We should not bring up the gay porn.
You just did, you idiot!
Autumn said it first!
Oh my god.
Tell us! They're like, tell us!
Okay, should we tell them the secret behind it, though?
No.
Okay.
We should probably let this one go.
Yeah, say it. We found gay porn on his phone.
Up to the lemonade stand, and he said to the man in front of the stand, hey!
Bum, bum, bum. Got any grapes? On Cal's phone, yes, we found gay porn on his phone.
Hey, let me tell you what, that's some shit.
Really, yes, really, we found it on his phone. Yes, we asked him about it, and apparently he doesn't know how it got there. Just like he didn't know where the hamburgers went either.
This was over a year ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there might be a whole lot more on there now.
He wanted to learn some moves.
He did deny it, too. That's the thing. He doesn't know how it got there. That's his story. He doesn't know how it got on his phone.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. That ain't the reason why he's sticking to it. Alright.
Does he like anything like that in bed? No.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Beep, beep, time out. I don't want to know.
David's live and he must be mad. Can you hop on David's live?
Prepare to be captivated by the intense verbal battle that unfolds in the next segment, spanning a gripping 30 minutes. Kyle initiates a phone call to David, igniting a tumultuous confrontation that escalates into a full-blown family feud. Brace yourself as Kyle's stepmother, Tammy, and even Autumn join the fray, exchanging verbal blows that cut deep. Pay close attention while they air out each other's most private, dirty laundry.
No, take it in here so people can hear it.
I get smoke and cigarette.
Hello?
Put the old man on the phone.
Please. You can tell us this. And by the way,
He wasn't talking shit.
One, he wasn't talking shit. It was him joking around.
No. It was a cheeseburger thing and about the freaking stuff that found
talk about you having
gay
porn on your phone.
It's a joke.
It's been a joke
for 2 years.
No. You're saying,
why is she saying that? I don't give a fuck the way they said it. It's a fucking joke either way.
No.
Hello.
Okay. Question.
Hello.
Question. Did you send a message on TikTok Live saying, if I stay with Kenisha, you don't want shit to do with me?
No, I did not.
I got it on screen record. Don't lie.
You can say what you want, but no, I did not. Oh, you never watched that. You want to do TV, so replace it. No, I did not.
This lie is awful.
I never once said that. I said I didn't want to do it with your son, her family. I said nothing about nothing to do with you. I said, you were one of your...
She don't give two shits about you.
I love my son. I love Kyle to death. But as long as he's with her, I'm done with him. I'm out.
Okay. I'm saying this now, Dad. I just saw the screen recording and heard it.
It came out of your mouth.
And it, you said, as long as I am with her, you are done.
Not with him.
That's the way it comes out on that screen recording.
I am done with him. That literally was your words.
The words were, send me that screen recording and I'm gonna send it to him.
Hold on. Stay on the phone, David.
We do around here when he's here.
Listen.
Stay quiet for a minute.
I get that.
Listen to this. You say him. You do not say them. Listen.
Ask her what her true feelings about Kyle is, and if she just changes the subject and don't even answer. Come on now.
Wait.
I'm done trying to stick up for her when it's obvious. She don't give two shits about him. I love my son. I love Kyle to death. But as long as he's with her, I'm done with him.
That came out of your mouth. I'm done with him. Am I a guy?
It said him, but did not say them.
I said them.
You said him.
Not him. Listen to it carefully. Open your earballs and listen to it.
That's my thing.
It said them.
And
them, not him. Not H-E-M, them.
Anyway, as far as that goes, I can care less about that shit. But it pissed me off a little bit. But as far as them, you saying that they're talking shit, it's a fucking joke. It's been
No, sir, what I don't take is a joke. Yes, the hamburger things, yes, I get that. Okay, you know how we are about that shit. I told you about that. As far as you get a job, I jumped your ass about that. As far as you quitting a job when she got fired from the hell because of her sickness, and you quit your job right behind her, I jumped your ass about that. What pissed me off was when her dad said, quote, the next time he makes me mad, I'm sending him to see Jesus.
A joke, David. It's a fucking joke.
Don't take that as a joke.
Well, you might want to learn what a joke is. You're a fucking full-grown man. Learn what a fucking joke is.
You don't talk about killing somebody. Anybody.
Oh, so it makes it okay for you to threaten my dad, but not the other way around?
Your dad? He can't even fucking work.
Yeah, he blew his back out working for us fucking kids.
All I am saying is this. If you and Aaron have a fucking problem, talk it out or fight it out man to man.
Her side.
He needs. And I know he is. And that's fine. I already expected that. No, it's not. He's our son. He's more than welcome anytime he wants. But as far as commission and the rest of them, I don't want nothing to do with them.
Of course you don't. You don't know what a fucking joke is. When we get married, you guys are not welcome.
I hung up.
Babe, come here. Come back. I got some more to fucking say.
No, I'm saying it. That way it comes out of my mouth. If he's gonna be that way, they're not welcome at the wedding.
I literally did nothing fucking wrong to him. There was no fucking reason for him to treat me like that.
I need a cigarette.
You reached
me. You have to call Tammy. He's on live.
This is coming out of my mouth, so don't blame Kenisha because it's not coming out of her mouth. If you don't fucking like her or anything that like that, you guys don't need to be coming to the fucking wedding. Because I'm not having... Because I'm not having bullshit get started, though.
I didn't plan on it. And I'm going to tell you exactly what I said a while ago. Before anybody else tries to tell you, I'm going to tell you about coming straight from my mouth. Because, son, you know... From the very beginning of this, if you two get back together, I was the first to support you in this relationship. When you guys got back together, the first. From this point forward, I do not support it. And I damn sure don't support you guys' wedding. So I will not be at your wedding.
Okay.
For two reasons. One, if I do, I promise you I'm going to fucking jail. Two, if I come, I will be the first one to stand up and say, when soon as that crazy says, if anybody's got a problem with this, stand up and speak now, grab hold your peace. I will be the first one to stand up and say something. So no, I'm not coming to a wedding. Three, I'm going to say this now, before somebody else says something, because I already know if this boy ever got back to you, because I just said the wrong line. I don't give a shit. No, I'm not trying to break you guys up. Do I want you guys together? Hell no. But do I want you guys to break up? So am I trying to break you up? No, I don't give a shit if you guys together or not, to be honest. That's on you. Do what you want to do. You're a grown adult. But if you think I want to sit back and an 80 good parent, and I got people on TikTok and anybody else that will back me the hell up on this. Any good parent. I don't give a shit if you're 1 or 101.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if you're a daughter or not. If you take care of yourself or not.
I'm about to go off.
Any good parent will take care of their child no matter how old they are.
Hold on. You say good parent, right?
Don't even bring up the past, Kyle.
Why? When it's true. He left on my second birthday and didn't come back in my life until I was 17 and a half.
Well, here we go.
Oh, good parent.
Again. That's my fault. Again.
It was your mother's fault.
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's always
Did it get unplugged?
The reason why I'm saying good that only because there was several times I was in a group home and it came time to for your visit and you never once showed up and never even called for the day you were going.
Bullshit.
You showed up once. I'm talking about when I was in middle school, you dumbass.
As far as the other times, I didn't even know about something if they didn't tell me.
Bullshit.
Yeah, bullshit. Okay. Believe what you want to believe. You always do. gonna leave everybody over me.
In my opinion, he is a space filler. He is a space filler so she don't have to be alone. Until somebody else better comes along for her.
And I'm gonna tell you what I told my mom.
That's what I truly feel.
Honestly, if you don't like me and Kenisha being together, you don't need to be alive.
For her to have somebody until somebody else or somebody better comes along. Somebody else or somebody better comes along. That's what I truly feel.
It's as simple as that.
In my opinion, he is a space filler. He is a space filler, so she don't have to be alone until somebody else better comes along for her.
Just wait until I get off the phone. I'm going to tell you what I told John. You, John, you know what I'm talking about.
David, nice.
Where were you when we were homeless, needing somewhere to fucking stay? You weren't there. Talk about support and let your own son sleep out on the fucking street.
And that one, you have a point on. Yeah, because you want to let hope.
My bomb heart hurts for like, yeah. Literally, want to go get you.
I refuse.
Thank you for the follow.
I refuse because you want to let hope be, though.
No. Maybe it's a nice spread paper.
Bullshit. Bullshit. Autumn and John are sitting right here, right now, when we were sleeping in a fucking tent, you didn't offer that shit. We were outside in the middle of the fucking winter, negative degrees.
They all put places.
Kenisha, accept it. Thank you.
Talked about it, but never said we could.
John's not there, y'all.
Yeah, this is the reason why.
John is Autumn's boyfriend.
I heard my name.
No, they think that John.
I'm talking about when we were homeless. And you guys were like 505 North Central.
Thank you for the follow up.
We could have you living with us, and you know why.
Kenisha, explain that Autumn's boyfriend.
I barely can hear you.
Can you hear me now?
He's still your son, though.
My heart hurts for her, too.
I never claimed I was perfect. I'm far from fucking perfect.
Thank you for the roses. No, Kenisha, stick up for yourself. I'd smack him.
And even then, we did all you there because of Sonny, and you know that. Because Sonny would have kicked your ass.
So where did he offer you guys both to go?
My in-laws would never.
Sonny?
Yeah, because Sonny would have kicked your ass. Sonny would have.
Oh, tell that to DJ and Cordy when I was living. Tell that to DJ and Cordy when I was living with them.
Well, that was you. Because you was living with us in the trailer. If we would have let Kenisha move in with us and he would have fucking found out, he would have been pissed because he tried to get here because he thought fucking Zach would move in with us and he thought Kenisha was Zach. He thought Zach was moving in and that was your mom's son.
Yeah, whatever.
See, there, you just show she don't give a fuck about nobody but you and her. You give two shit about your baby brother.
That's bullshit. That's all he ever talks about is Junior.
Oh, I'm sorry that we have several shit that we have to fucking do. That we don't have fucking time.
You guys are just mad that he's with me, so you're gonna take it out and bring Junior into it, which he has no right to be brought into the situation, because this is an adult situation, not a child situation. So leave him out of it.
That's fine, ask John. What I'm gonna do is they're not gonna like me. I'm gonna hate doing it, but they're not gonna like me. Oh, they don't.
What?
No water. Fish bus. Both you tested. I'm gonna hate fucking doing it, but I'm not having my brother stay though.
But that's okay though.
I'm gonna absolutely hate doing it, but
exactly what you're saying.
The house is unlivable for a child.
Exactly. What you're saying. Yeah, so yeah, that really shows you care about your brother, not.
I care probably more than you about him.
Oh, really?
Really.
Really?
What?
What
you
saying? Really?
What?
What do you say?
Mention that he's staying in bed, though. He should be staying there. There's no water in that place. He should be staying there. But don't mention that certain part.
How is that?
See, I don't see you here day in and day out taking care of him. I don't see you changing his ass. I don't see you feeding him. I don't see you stressing.
You're the parent. That's your job, not his.
I don't see you going to school when he needs a meeting. I don't see you fucking doing anything for him. I don't see you taking the fucking doctor.
Good.
I don't see you putting fucking medicine down his mouth when he needs to sit. Or only when he's sick.
No, but who the fuck does he come to every time I'm there? Not you guys.
And not just that.
That's you guys' responsibility to do that, not mine. If it was mine, I would show the fuck do it.
That doesn't mean you care for him more than I do. That makes a whole lot of sense, son. That just shows how fucking stupid you truly are.
Wow. Did he seriously just call you stupid?
You really want to call me stupid? You guys are gonna hate me and disown me for what I'm thinking about doing.
Okay.
And what do you think about doing?
You guys find out soon enough. That's all I gotta say.
He never once said he was calling CPS on you. That's bullshit. He never once said that.
I am a bastard and proud of it. My parents weren't married when they had me.
Never mind. I'm a bastard.
And what are you gonna call CPS for?
Yeah.
He's got a roof over his head and food in his stomach.
Yeah, but the house is not technically livable because there's no water. It's cockroach infested, bed bug infested, not suitable for an infant or a toddler. Okay. Yeah, but no running water. So it's bed bug infested. It's bed bug infested and it's cockroach infested.
Okay, whatever. Yeah, the
cockroaches
are here with the landlords here. Boom.
Yeah, so then again, how.
Open cockroaches too.
Then again, how hard is it to bomb? How hard is it to bomb a place? Not hard.
Well, see,
get roach bombs.
We don't go on TikTok to bomb, to beg for money to get stuff that we need.
We don't beg.
Congratulations.
We're not begging. We weren't begging, and what did you do?
She's been begging on TikTok. She's been bringing her food and delivering food.
I didn't ask for that. That got delivered here. It was a surprise when it showed up. I didn't ask for that shit. I want to grab her by her fucking throat.
I guarantee you they would not be saying this to our faces if we were standing there.
No, they wouldn't. And my phone, I bought myself. My phone, I pay for my own shit.
She never once
Maybe because
of,
maybe because she doesn't want to post that shit on fucking live.
If I really loved him, I wouldn't be sticking up for him for my dad. Bullshit!
It was a
fucking joke. Get your dick out of your fucking ass.
It was a fucking joke. Learn how to take a goddamn joke.
Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna go around and kill you. Oh, okay.
Made a joke when she was laughing at that thing about killing you. Made a joke calling you fat, lazy, and stupid, and all this other shit.
That
was a joke.
Yeah. And he was laughing about it, David. If you were actually paying attention, it was a fucking joke. Do you really want to start this right now?
Not the way your dad said it.
Oh.
Boo fucking who? Grow the fuck up.
Oh my god.
Where'd the cheeseburgers go? Where'd the cheeseburgers go?
Don't give a fuck.
Where'd the cheeseburgers go?
Hold on. You really piss them off? You really want to piss them off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
For one.
Congratulations.
For one, Dad. It's a fucking joke. Take a joke. Maybe actually, if you actually can get your fucking dick pump to work and quit texting other fucking bitches other than mom and having me send you people to fucking text. Yeah, mom.
Yeah, I'm trying to get with my mom while you're with Tammy. That's a great one. Supposedly pushed me out of the truck. He did push me out of the truck, you dumb bitch.
Oh, really? Tammy, go through his fucking phone. I guarantee you he won't let you.
You both lose your FSI. You both lose your FSI. You're both gonna be broke. Nobody's gonna have money. Your mom's not gonna have her thing.
Why do you think they make you on TikTok?
Tell those bitches that's on your lap to shut the fuck up. It's a family matter, not doesn't belong with them. But anyway, I'm gonna get off here because I don't need this stupid bullshit drama between you guys trying to start shit because it ain't gonna break me and Kenisha up. No, because you're the one that started a whole bunch of shit with Kenisha. Of a fucking joke.
Well, if your question made sense, I might have answered it.
And she didn't even answer that. And I got all this drama started. I asked one question, and that was it.
Yeah, whatever.
If you'd like to say something different, calling CPS on someone because your mom makes you look like a douchebag, just saying.
Bitch, shut the fuck up.
And your mom's why I started, right? Exactly. Your mom's why you don't call CPS on me.
And try to get your brother to take a look at me. That shows how good of a person you truly are. That would truly care about your brother, right? That really, for one, if I would to do it, I wouldn't be trying because they would have me work with those bugs of fucking not having water and all that. They'll easily take them.
We got water.
What
water jugs?
Jugs?
Yeah, but water.
Yeah, they won't consider that at all. No, they won't.
That's okay.
Let's see. I've been in the system longer than you guys ever have.
I was in the system. Half my life.
She's not a lying bitch. And she's not a cunt like you.
Oh, yeah, I am a cunt. I love it.
You're a two-faced fucking cunt ass bitch.
Yes, I am.
You can't see the flying fact that the old bastard in front of you is cheating on you by texting several fucking bitches.
Including my mom.
Including April.
You better add, by tomorrow, 2 o'clock, all your shit, the shit is either gonna be out in the road or in the trash can.
Bitch, try me. I'm still getting mail there. You can't fucking do that unless you do a 30-day fucking thing to kick my ass out.
You wouldn't be here for 30 days. Thank you.
If I'm still getting mail, that's legal. You have to get...
30-day eviction notice.
No, because you get fucking married.
You have to give me a 30-day eviction notice because I'm getting mail, though.
My house.
Bitch, look it up.
I'll be like, bitch, I'm cleaning out this room. Nobody's staying in this room. It's trash. What are you going to say?
Oh, I'm...
Because you're abandoned, you've not been here for 30 days.
Yep.
To get anything.
Yep.
I'm still getting mail, though, so... You still... Yes, it does. Look it up. Call the fucking police department. Go ahead. The cops will even tell you. If I'm getting mail, though, you have to give me a 30-day eviction notice. Well, I'm getting off of it because I don't need your fucking stupid-ass bullshit dumbassness. Out of the first and last month, yes.
Yeah, we got water.
Out of the first and last month, yes.
Because Idaho has water rights where, like, if a person is staying in your home for more than, like, 3 days, you have to, like, go to the courts to get them to get him evicted.
Yes, he's not staying here for over a month. He's not staying here for over a month.
I'm getting off here, you dumb piece of the shit. Oh, tell her that she's safe to come in. And all three of you guys know, DCS would take Junior in a heartbeat. I would hate fucking doing it. 100%. I would definitely hate doing it.
Hey.
I don't want to do something right now, but I'm not going to do it. And I know damn well you ain't going to take me to go do it. Something dealing with the house at my dad's. Huh? Something dealing with that with my dad's. You killed him?
Yeah. Do you like the world's best chocolate?
or chocolate.
Nobody laughed at my joke that I made about you, Kyle.
What joke?
I see you sucking down on your fingers from the truck.
I'm sorry, I didn't even hear you when you said...
This revelation sparks the first of many fights between Kenisha and Kyle's family, leading to Kyle becoming the subject of the infamous inside cheeseburger joke.
Not even close to being done with it yet. Oh my god. They said, let's talk about the hamburger.
All right, let's talk about the hamburger.
She said, no, I'm just playing.
Missing cheeseburgers. Kay's laughing now. Oh, about a year ago when Kyle ate the hamburgers, but tried to say somebody broke into the hotel room. Kyle. Let's talk. Let's get it all out in the open.
I didn't eat the hamburgers.
Who did?
I don't know.
The person who that ate? Broke in and stole them.
Well, I guess that's one of the things I'm going to be buying throughout next month. I'm going to buy one of them $69 lie detector tests. Yeah, for Kyle, we're going to find out if he ate the cheeseburgers or not. And if it proves that he's lying, then he has to buy $69 worth of cheeseburgers. And he has to eat them all on TikTok Live.
You best have a bucket ready right beside me just in case I get sick.
Get new material.
Kane said he's going to put up the $20 and you can't finish it. There's an open challenge.
I don't know if I'll be able to finish it, so I'm not putting money on it.
What if he's telling the truth?
Well, then I just wasted $67 on a lie detector test. I'll have fun with it, though.
Haha, probably someone actually stole them.
Somebody probably what?
They said, haha, someone actually stole them. No.
Yeah, Kyle's mouth. See, I'm going to tell the story all over again. Some people on here may not have heard the story. So, Kenisha and Kaylee had to go somewhere. And they left the cheeseburgers in the bag. On the dresser. They come back and they're gone. Now, this is a story of what happened to them poor cheeseburgers when they left. Kyle unwrapped the cheeseburger so seductively. He said, I'm going to wrap my lips around you. I am going to eat your pickle. And then that's the story of how the cheeseburger died. Cheeseburgers died.
Yes.
I know what happened next. The next thing you did was you got a hold of a McChicken. That part is to be continued.
So they're like, so someone stole the hamburgers and nothing else? Yes.
Yeah, it was Kyle.
We now fast forward to March 18th, and Kenisha declares that she won't be moving to Stacy's place. It is clear Kyle wants to visit his mother.
I'm gonna go ahead and get off him, Mom. I'll call you later on tonight.
Alright.
I love you.
Then you offer to come home and help, but...
I love you.
Talk to you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Now you see why I'm calling.
Do what you want. I'm not moving out to your mom's. The way they treat me and the way they put me down? No. I'm not going out there.
I thought the meaning I don't. I will talk about it.
If you want to go out to your mom's, go out there. But you know, I hate to say it, I don't do long distance. I'm not doing long distance. Because it never works out.
Damn, I don't have a way out there though.
So how come get you?
My mom's not able to drive.
I just heard her say she'll drive if she has to.
Yeah, but we'll go out and I'm not going to have that happen.
I don't know. Guys, I'm going to have to get off here soon because the library closes at 4 and that's in 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. back to my mom's.
Kenisha is against this decision.
The following day, Kyle says he is going to visit his mom, who is believed to be on her deathbed. The emotional roller coaster continues as Kenisha decides to break up with Kyle.
Not a good day today.
Huh?
Not a good day today? I'll be here a little while longer, but not very long.
Okay. Why would I want to go somewhere where I'm being disrespected all the time? He can't even call his mom without her treating me like crap. I'm not going down there. I already told him, and it's not me being mean, but I'm not doing online relationship. It never works. I never said I didn't support him taking care of his mom.
As March draws to a close, Kenisha takes a hiatus from live streaming, leaving viewers on the edge of their seats, eagerly anticipating her enigmatic return.